am Shirish Deshpande with interesting second episode of B Pharma on important unit of group estimation part 2, which is a section of pharmaceutical analysis 1 of fourth semester. With previous lecture knowledge, we will be going further to learn other methods used for the determination of functional groups. Let us start with a quick look at what we are going to learn today. Module number 1, introduction. Module number 2, determination of carboxylic acids by iodometric titration. Module number 3, determination of phenols by bromination. Module number 4, determination of alcohols and phenols by acetylation. Module 5, determination of aldehydes and ketones by oxymation. Module number 6, determination of methoxy compounds by redox titration. Module number 1, introduction. Large number of organic compounds contains one or more functional groups such as hydroxyl, amino, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acids, esters, sulfonamido, phenolic, alkoxy, etc. These functional groups may be present in aliphatic, alicyclic, aromatic, and heterocyclic compounds. The analysis of functional groups for quantitative determination can be done in different ways. Large number of methods based on chemical reactions of functional groups can thus be used for their estimations. In this lecture, some alternative routinely adopted methods which are used for estimation of compounds containing these functional groups will be discussed. Most of the methods will be discussed with theory related to the experimental procedure. In this lecture, we are going to discuss methods which we have not applied in previous lecture. Which methods we have discussed in previous lecture? Like gravimetric analysis, aqueous and non-aqueous acid-base titrations. In this lecture, we are going to learn methods which are recognized on the basis of reactions. These methods are applied for the quantitative analysis of chemical constituents present in plant extracts or essential oils or plant metabolites. Module number 2, determination of carboxylic acids by iodometric titration. Dear students, we have studied carboxylic acid estimation by gravimetric, aqueous and non-aqueous acid-base titration methods. The carboxylic acid estimation can also be done by iodometry. Theory: when a solution of acid is treated with an excess of neutral solution of potassium iodide and potassium iodate, the hydrogen ion of the acid yields equivalent amount of iodine, which can be determined by titration with a standard sodium thiosulfate solution. This method is particularly advantageous in the titration of very dilute solutions of strong carboxylic acid. It gives very sharp color change as end point of titration. For solution of weak acids, the iodometric titration is difficult. Why it is difficult? Reason is, when hydrogen ions are removed by reaction with potassium iodate and potassium iodide, a buffer system of weak carboxylic acid like RCOOH and its salt, that is RCOOK, is produced. This results in availability of low concentration of hydrogen ions. Because of this low concentration of hydrogen ions, rate of reaction between hydrogen ions, iodate and iodide may become very small. The entire reaction can be summarized in this way. See the reaction on the screen. Potassium iodate plus potassium iodide plus carboxylic acid result in the formation of salt of carboxylic acid, and 3 molecules of iodine are evolved in the reaction. Can we overcome this problem? Yes. This experimental difficulty can be overcome by adding an excess of standard sodium thiosulfate solution after the introduction of the iodate-iodide solution. The iodine formed in the reaction is thus removed and the reaction velocity is increased considerably. Iodine reacts with a sodium thiosulfate to form sodium iodide and sodium tetrathionate. Ultimately, the excess of thiosulfate remaining after completion of reaction is back titrated with a standard iodine solution. Let us see the procedure. The procedure is similar to iodometric titration with some modification, where back titration is performed. Take 2 milliequivalents of the organic acid in 350 ml of iodine flask. Dissolve it in distilled water and add 20 ml of the potassium iodate, potassium iodide reagent, followed by 40 ml of standard 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Allow the mixture to stand for 15 to 30 minutes and titrate the excess of thiosulfate with the standard 0.1 normal iodine solution in the presence of starch as an indicator, which is added near the end point of titration. The purity of the carboxylic acid is calculated by multiplying net volume of sodium thiosulfate solution consumed by sample, that is V, and its normality, that is N1, multiplied by molecular weight of the acid M and multiplied by 100, divided by weight of sample taken W, and divided by basicity of acidity, that is N, and divided the result by 1000. The equivalent weight of the acid is the weight of acid which reacts with 1000 ml of 1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Determination of polyhydric alcohol in phytochemical can be done by iodometry using Malaprade reaction also. Module 3, determination of phenols by bromination. So far, we have learned one method for the determination of phenols by non-aqueous titration method. Now, we are going to learn another method for the determination of phenols. Let us see how the first method differing from second in terms of principle theory. In this method, bromination of phenol is done with excess of standard bromate-bromide solution in the presence of hydrochloric acid. The reaction equation that see on the screen, that potassium bromate reacts with the potassium bromide in presence of hydrochloric acid, produces 3 molecules of bromine, 6 molecules of potassium chloride and 3 molecules of water. The excess of bromine is determined by the addition of potassium iodide solution and the titration of the liberated iodine with a standard sodium thiosulfate solution. See the reaction on screen. Bromine reacts with the potassium iodide, results in the liberation of iodine and formation of potassium bromide. The result of experiment may be varied due to variation in temperature, quantity of bromine and the time of reaction. The best results are obtained at room temperature or below room temperature. The excess of bromine must be controlled in order to reduce side chain bromination. Phenol yields 2,4,6 tribromophenol. The reaction can be shown as, see it on the screen. Phenol reacts with 3 molecules of bromine, gives 2,4,6 tribromophenol plus 3 molecules of hydrogen bromide. One should note that the presence of hydrogen or of nitrogen group in the ortho and para position does not hinder the bromination. Hydroxyl or amino groups in the ortho and para position hinder the entrance of bromine into the ring. Carboxyl and sulfonic acids groups seems to behave in an intermediate manner. A dibromo product is first formed upon standing with excess of bromine. The tiabromo derivative is produced with the elimination of the carboxyl group or sulfonic acid group. Thus, salicylic acid yields a 2,4,6 tribromophenol. A average bromination period is 30 minutes using about 100% excess of bromine. For the analysis of ester or salicylic acid, they must be hydrolyzed with the dilute alkali before bromination. Let us see the procedure. How to perform this titration? Weigh accurately about 0.25 grams of the phenol. Dissolve it in 5 ml of 10% sodium hydroxide solution and dilute the solution to 250 ml in a volumetric flask. Pipette out 25 ml of phenol solution into a 500 ml iodine flask, followed by 25 ml of the bromate bromide solution and dilute with 25 ml of water. Add 5 ml of concentrated hydrochloric acid and stopper the flask immediately. Shake the flask for 1 minute to mix the reactants and allow to stand for 30 minutes with occasional shaking of the flask. Cool the flask under the ice water. Place 10 ml of 20% potassium iodide solution in the cup around the stopper. Slightly dislodge the stopper, whereupon the iodide solution is drawn into the flask with no loss of bromine. Shake the flask well and allow to stand for 10 minutes. Remove the stopper and wash the neck of the flask and the stopper with a little water. Titrate the evolved iodine, which is equivalent to the excess of bromine taken, with 0.1 normal sodium thiosulfate and about 1 ml of starch as indicator near the end point of titration. Carry out the blank analysis using 25 ml of the bromate bromide reagent and 25 ml of water. Percentage purity of the phenol can be calculated by multiplying difference between volume in ml of sodium thiosulfate solution used for the blank, that is V2, and volume of sodium thiosulfate solution used for the sample, that is V1, multiplied by normality of sodium thiosulfate solution, that is N1, multiplied by molecular weight of phenol, that is M, divided by weight of the sample taken in grams, W, and divided by number of bromine atoms substituted in the phenol, that is Z, and divided by 2000, module 4. Determination of alcohols and phenols by acetylation. Let us discuss the method of analysis of alcohol first. The hydroxyl group in alcohol is determined by two ways. First is by acetylation and second is by phthalation. Let us see the theory of alcohol estimation by acetylation. This method involves the replacement of hydrogen on an alcoholic hydroxyl group by acetyl group. The reagent consists of a solution of acetic anhydride in pure pyridine and is used in excess. The reaction equation is as ROH plus CH3CO alcohol plus acetic anhydride, which results in the formation of acetic acid and ester. The addition of water converts the excess of acetic anhydride into acetic acid. The total free acetic acid is then titrated with a standard sodium hydroxide solution. The equation can be written as acetic anhydride plus water results in the formation of acetic acid. This acetic acid reacts with the sodium hydroxide to form sodium acetate and water. To have accurate result, blank determination is also performed. In this method, pyridine is used as a solvent in acetylation because it is inactive towards the reagents. It removes the acid produced by salt formation and it is also serves as a catalyst. The reaction equation explains the role of pyridine. Alcohol reacts with the acetic anhydride in the presence of pyridine, results in the formation of ester, then pyridine which has accepted one proton and acetate ion. Then water reacts with acetic anhydride in presence of that pyridine, results in the formation of acetate ions and then pyridine molecule. There is another method by which hydroxyl estimation can be done is a thalation method, which is similar to that of acetylation. In this reaction, the thalic anhydride is used instead of acetic anhydride. If we compare the kinetic of the reaction, acetylation reaction is more rapid than thalation. Large excess of thalic anhydride is required for completion of reaction is a disadvantage of thalation method. Procedure. How to analyze this hydroxyl compound percentage purity? Weigh accurately 1 to 2.5 milliequivalents of sample containing hydroxyl group into 250 ml iodine flask and add 3 ml of acetylating reagent. Moist the glass topper with pyridine and set it loosely. Heat the flask on steam bath for 45 minutes. Add 5 to 6 ml of water to the cup around the stopper. Loosen the stopper so that water rinses down the stopper and the walls of the flask. Swirl the contents of the flask to ensure thorough mixing and heat for 2 minutes more. Cool the flask under running water or in ice with the stopper partially open. Rinse the stopper and the side of the flask with 5 to 10 ml of N-butanol. Add few drops of mixed indicator and titrate the contents with 0.5 normal alcoholic sodium hydroxide to gray color. Perform Planck determination on 3 ml of the reagent simultaneously and similar in all respects except addition of sample. The difference between the volumes of alkali used in the two titrations corresponds to the alcohol which has reacted. If the compounds which yields high colored solutions should be titrated potentiometrically instead of using visual indicators. You can calculate the percentage purity of hydroxyl in the sample by formula. See the formula where V1 is a volume in ml of sodium hydroxide solution used in blank. V2 is a volume of sodium hydroxide solution used for sample. N1 is the normality of alkali. W is the weight of sample taken in grams. Determination of phenols. We will start with the theory of determination of phenols by acetylation with acetic anhydride in pyridine. The acetylation method involves the replacement of the hydrogen on a phenolic hydroxyl group by acetyl. The reagent consists of a solution of acetic anhydride in pure pyridine and is used in excess. The principle is very much similar to the hydroxyl estimation in alcohol by acetylation. See the reaction equation where phenol reacts with acetic anhydride in presence of pyridine results in the formation of ester and carboxylic acid. Due to similar principle, what we all learn in estimation of hydroxyl group of alcohol by acetylation, we will not go on repeating the same thing. Let us see the procedure. Weigh accurately into a 250 ml of iodine flask, sufficient of sample to contain 1 to 2.5 milliequivalent of hydroxyl sample. Add 3 ml of the acetylating reagent. Complete the determination in a similar manner as mentioned in alcohol estimation. Perform a blank determination on 3 ml of the acidic anhydride pyridine reagent simultaneously and similar in all respects. Calculate the percentage purity of phenolic hydroxyl in the sample using the formula, where V1 is a volume in ml of sodium hydroxide solution used in blank, V2 is the volume of sodium hydroxide solution used for the sample, N1 is the normality of alkali and W is the weight of sample. Module 5. Determination of aldehyde and ketone by oxymation. Let us discuss the theory behind the analysis. When percent of aldehyde or ketone is less in essential oil, this method is preferred. The aldehyde or ketone present in the essential oil react with hydroxylamine hydrochloride reagent to form oxime, and hydrochloric acid is liberated. See the reaction, that ketone reacts with hydroxylamine hydrochloride and equivalent amount of hydrochloric acid is generated in the reaction. This reaction is reversible. The equilibrium of reversible reaction is displaced to the right in the presence of pyridine and by addition of excess of hydroxylamine hydrochloride, and the reaction may be regarded as virtually complete. The pyridine combines with the hydrogen chloride to form pyridine hydrochloride. See the reaction equation. This ketone or aldehyde react with hydroxylamine hydrochloride in the presence of hydrochloric acid results in the formation of oxime and hydrochloride salt of pyridine. Pyridine hydrochloride is sufficiently acidic to be titrated with a standard methanolic sodium hydroxide using bromophenol blue as indicator. The rate of reaction between carbonyl compound and hydroxylamine varies somewhat depending upon the groups R and R dash, which are substituent. Some compounds like propionaldehyde, furfuraldehyde, benzaldehyde and acetone reacts quantitatively in 30 minutes at the laboratory temperature, whereas other compounds, that is acetophenone, benzophenone, benzoine and camphor, may require heating for 2 hours at 90 to 100 degrees Celsius for completion of reaction. Let us see the procedure. Place 30 ml of the hydroxylamine hydrochloride reagent and 100 ml of the pyridine indicator solution in a 250 ml glass toppered flask and add not more than 10 milliequivalents of the aldehyde or alicyclic ketone accurately weighed to the contents of the flask. Stopper the flask and allow it to stand at laboratory temperature for 30 minutes. Meanwhile, carry out blank determination omitting the addition of carbonyl compound and titrate with the 0.5 normal methanolic sodium hydroxide to a blue-green color. Keep the resulting solution for use as a color standard. Now titrate the hydrochloric acid liberated during the oxymation of the sample with 0.5 normal methanolic sodium hydroxide until the color of the solution matches that of the blank. It should be noted that oxime's formation is rather slow for most of the aromatic compounds and ketones. Place 30 ml of hydroxylamine hydrochloride reagent and 100 ml of the pyridine bromophenol blue solution in a 250 ml conical flask fitted with a ground in condenser. Weigh out accurately not more than 10 milliequivalents of the ketone into the flask. Heat the mixture on a boiling water bath for 2 hours. Allow to cool. Titrate the liberated hydrochloric acid with 0.5 normal methanolic sodium hydroxide until the color of the indicator matches that of the blank, subjected to the same experimental conditions. You can calculate the percentage purity of the carbonyl compound from the formula, where V1 is the volume of sodium hydroxide solution used for the sample. N1 is the normality of methanolic sodium hydroxide. M is the molecular weight of carbonyl compound, and W is the weight of sample taken. Determination of methoxy compound by redox titration. We have already learned gravimetric estimation of this type of compounds. The more appropriate method for the methoxy group analysis is titrimetric method. Using this method, small quantity of analyte can be determined satisfactorily. Let us see the theory. A known weight of compound is decomposed by heating with constant boiling hydroiodic acid, whereby it yielding the volatile methyl iodide. That reaction equation is, when methoxy compound treated with hydroiodic acid results in the formation of alcohol and methyl iodide. It is more convenient to use a volumetric procedure to determine the methyl iodide formed in the reaction. The alkyl iodide is absorbed in an acetic acid solution of sodium acetate containing bromine. Under these conditions, iodine monobromide is first formed, which is further oxidized to iodic acid. See the reaction. Methyl iodide reacts with bromine to form methyl bromide and iodobromine. The iodic acid is determined by diluting with water, adding concentrated sodium acetate solution and destroying the excess of bromine with formic acid. See the reaction equation. The liquid is then acidified with sulfuric acid. Potassium iodide solution is added and the liberated iodine is titrated with standard sodium thiosulfate solution. See the reaction. It is clear that a very favorable conversion factor results. That is, since 6 times the original quantity of iodine is ultimately liberated, the equivalence can be shown in this way. Methoxy group is equal to that methyl iodide is equivalent to hydroiodic acid is equivalent to 3 molecules of iodine, which is equivalent to 6 molecules of sodium thiosulfate, or 1 ml of 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate is equivalent to 0.2586 milligrams of methoxy compound. Special apparatus is required for the estimation of methoxy group in phytochemicals. Apparatus can be described in this way. The apparatus consists of a Pyrex 2 naked round bottomed 100 ml flask AB fitted with a 2 standard ground glass joints, A Liebig condenser, C and a trap D is attached at A. The trap D is connected to 2 test tube receivers, that is E and F, by means of ground glass joints. G is merely a safety tube which serves to collect any liquid should the passage of gas through the apparatus accidentally become unduly fast. The capillary tubing possessing through the ground joint at B is connected to source of carbon dioxide. For example, a Kipps apparatus via small bubbler containing water. H is a device by means of which the vapor of the liquid boiling in the flask can be passed through the condenser C. It requires no attention once the liquid is boiling at a steady rate. The reaction flask is immersed in the oil bath. The latter carries a thermometer and is heated by the burner. Procedure. The experimental procedure can be described in this way. Clean the apparatus with chromic acid, rinse well with tap water, then with distilled water, and finally dry in an air oven at 120 degrees Celsius. Assemble the apparatus as shown in the figure. Lubricate all ground glass joints lightly with silicone's stopcock grease. Charge the trap D with sufficient antimony sodium tartrate solution to just cover the internal tube. This reagent will effectively absorb hydroiodic acid, iodine and hydrogen sulfide, but will not retain the alkyl iodide. Place 10 to 12 ml of the acetic acid sodium acetate bromine solution in E and an equal volume in F. Weigh out accurately about 25 milligrams of solid sample, for example vanillin, into a small tin foil cup. The cup may be made by cutting off the corners of the small square of thin tin foil and then pressing this rough circle into a cup around the end of glass rod. After weighing, lightly close the cup by pinching the edges together and then introduce it carefully into the reaction flask through B. Disconnect the flask for this purpose. Add about 0.5 grams of phenol, 1.0 ml of the redistilled propionic anhydride and a few small carborundum chips. Warm the reaction mixture gently to dissolve the sample. It is important that the sample is completely dissolved before adding the hydroiodic acid. Attach the flask to the condenser G. Introduce 10 ml of analytical grade reagent hydroiodic acid through the neck B. Insert the capillary tube and connect to the source of carbon dioxide. Pass chloroform vapor through the jacket of the Leibniz condenser C for 10 minutes and heat the oil bath gradually. Adjust the rate of passage of the carbon dioxide through the apparatus so that the rate of bubbling in the receiver E and F is under control. The temperature of oil bath should reach 145 degrees Celsius in about 75 minutes. The reaction is then complete. Transfer the contents of the receiver E and F quantitatively to a 250 ml flask fitted with a ground glass stopper and containing 10 ml of 25% sodium acetate solution. Add analytical grade reagent formic acid drop by drop to the solution in the titration flask until the smell of bromine can no longer be detected. Insert the stopper, shake the flask well and cool it slightly. Carefully remove the stopper and wash it. Allow the washing to enter the flask. Then add a small drop of methyl red indicator solution. If the indicator is decolorized, add further drop of formic acid. Dilute the solution to about 100 ml and add 1 gram of potassium iodide and 10 ml of 10% sulfuric acid. Stopper the flask. Swirl the content gently and allow to stand topward for 3 to 5 minutes. Titrate the liberated iodine with standard 0.5 normal sodium thiosulfate solution using starch as indicator towards the end point of titration. To calculate the percentage of methoxyl in the sample from the formula used, as you can see on the screen, where V is the volume of 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate solution used in the determination, W is the weight in milligrams of sample taken, and 0.2586 is the factor. Now, we come to the end of today's lecture. Do keep it in mind what we discussed today. It is time for you all to do some self-study. This is Shirish Deshpande signing off. I will be back with one more lecture in this series. If you want to learn more and enhance your knowledge, you may log on to our website for MCQ, quizzes, LORs. Our website address is www.cec.nic.in. Till then, keep studying, goodbye, and stay connected with us. Thank you.